Interesting times for the Rangers.
What are they? What are you labeling it? Because we always hear those terms, rebuild. Mm-hmm. Some teams are retooling on the fly. What are the Rangers right now? Where are they?
Well, they're one of those things, whatever you want to call it. Jimmy himself called it rebuilding. Rebuild. I mean, yeah. They're trying to reload and restock. They don't probably want to bottom out. Everyone wants
a rebuild to is like tear it down.
I don't think they're looking to get the first overall pick next year, as it'll be great to have it.
Oh, yeah.
But they are trying to turn their roster over, get younger, infuse some of that youth and speed and skill. They got a young coach heading in that direction. That's what they're doing. And they have some good young pieces to do that with going forward. You know, it starts with their coach. You know, he's a young guy. He's got a lot of energy, got a lot of confidence. He's a bright guy. Coaching in the NHL is very different than coaching in college, and you'll probably have to adjust some of his personality or some of his player interactions to professionals as opposed to colleges. But
is it the game on the ice that's different, or just
no,
the personalities?
The personalities. It's the egos, it's the contracts, it's the locker room, it's different.
It's the men.
It's the men versus the boys. But he's got some good young pieces to work with coming up, and you know, Elias Anderson, Philip Chytil are both probably going to be on the team this year, plus some other high-end guys that they picked up this year. So the youth is coming. But when you're in a situation like this, ideally, Jameson, you kind of mix those young guys in the lineup. You probably have some years where you don't finish very good. You finish the bottom three, four, five. You try to get some of those high draft picks that will then take you to that level. Rangers aren't going to be able to do that because they don't have a goalie that will let them do that. And that's a compliment to Henrik Lundqvist. He said right away, when there was talk of this rebuild, a lot of people thinking about him, will he stay, will he go? And he came right up, got ahead of it. He's like, I'm not going anywhere. I'm a Ranger. I'm going to retire a Ranger. I don't want to get traded. I don't want to, you know, get out of here because things are not going to be as great as they once have been. But he's really good still. And he's too good to let his team finish in the bottom two or three with the group around him. So in many ways, Henrik Lundqvist, who has been the face of this franchise and the reason they've been great since he arrived in the mid 2000s is probably prohibiting them from really bottoming out, getting some of those draft picks and starting from scratch because he's just too good. So maybe not a perfect fit because he's too good,
yeah,
given where they're at right now in the next couple of years before they probably look to push forward to the playoffs and contending for a cup again in a couple of years.
They released that statement to the fans talking about their vision, their plan. The rebuild,
yes,
so to speak, when they trade away Ryan McDonagh, JT Miller to Tampa at the deadline. Are you surprised or impressed, I should say, that this team stayed the course throughout all that? Because we heard the rumblings about Ilya Kovalchuk coming back, wanting to stay in this area, possibly fitting in with the Rangers. But they said, no, they had the money, but they didn't need to throw the money at him.
Well, I guess surprised in the sense that the Rangers in the past have not always done that. They've often thrown their money at free agents and chased down some big-name guys to try to get good quickly. But there's no point in putting out a statement and having a plan if you can't stick to it for more than 3 or 4 months at a time. So if you're going to go to the lengths of trading important players like that and acknowledging to your fans and to your sponsors and to your season ticket holders that, yes, we're going to take a step back, but it's part of a process we're going through and there's a plan in place and it may take a couple of years, but we're going to get there, and then flip it, it would ring very hollow with the people that you are asking for their trust. So in that sense, I'm not surprised because it's the smart thing to do. It's the appropriate thing to do, whether you're the Rangers or the Carolina Hurricanes or whoever in between. It was wise that they stayed the course and didn't spend the money that they might have and didn't fill up their roster with aging players because they're going to get good when their young players get better.
Yeah, you made a great comparison earlier in our pre-show meeting with New York and Montreal and their goaltenders not allowing these two teams to bottom out. So which team is going to get better and back to the promised land quicker, do you think? Montreal or New York?
That's a really good question. I mean, I think probably New York because they are committed to where they're headed and they're on the path to get there. And that's part of the battle is acknowledging, okay, we're bottoming out, we're rebuilding, whatever you want to call it, and then we're going to get better. I don't think Montreal is quite there yet. I think Montreal still wants to compete, thinking if we get in the cut in the final or
that's
in the playoffs,
a retool versus a rebuild.
Maybe Carey Price can help us get through a round or two. You know, they're not quite sold on, we got to strip it down, get young players, get high draft picks, build through the draft, and then build back up. Whereas the Rangers are there, and they've started it. And we showed all those high picks they've had in the last few years. So for that reason, I would assume that the Rangers a bit of a leg up on who gets there first.
The bright lights of New York City, never a dull moment.